Double Hero Draft is here, and I'm going to be showing you guys how to absolutely dominate inside of this game mode. Let's jump into battle. Now, the hero selection is going to be the most crucial part of this mode here. Right now, we have probably one of the best combos, in my opinion, which is Barbarian King, Archer Queen. Barbarian King, just a solid tank with that invincibility. Even though he got the nerf, he's still pretty good. Archer Queen is going to be out here DPSing while being damage boosted. And an Archer Queen that is invisible and damage boosted is pretty strong. Pretty strong. Fortunately here, our opponent has the deer form first hand, so I don't know what that'll do. I'm a bit scared, but I mean, our Archer Queen are gonna pop invincibility here, and I think BK is gonna win the battle. And his Archer Queen, it has a health boost. Ooh, very cool. Okay, now Magic Archer, honestly, probably arguably one of the best minis in the game. So if you ever have the option to pick that, go ahead. You like, don't even think about the other mini. I'm gonna go Magic Archer on one side, Archer Queen on the other. This means the board, they're gonna have to walk towards like one end of the board to the other to get my support troops. So I think that's really, oh my god, I thought he was gonna pull my BK, dude. Look at that, our Magic Archer lining up shots. It's just beautiful, dude. It's just beautiful. Archer Queen gonna be raining down arrows, and that's gonna be round number two here. Level 12, I have a feeling like level 12 heroes are bots. Wizard Miner or Lumberjack Spirit Goblin. I think we honestly need some cheap elixir options. I'm gonna go Wizard Miner. Wizard for the anti-heal and Miner for any kind of support troops like his Archer Queen Witch combos. I'm gonna go Steel Tips, and since this guy has a Witch, he's probably not gonna think about sacking it, which is why I'm gonna go Magic Archer second ability. Let me try to get, oh, I don't have it, that's unfortunate. Okay, well, we have to improvise. I guess I'm gonna go Miner a lane switch, which I'm not gonna get. He gets the monk to my Archer Queen, but look at that. Magic Archer is onto the Archer Queen here. Look at the damage. So we're still getting the Magic Archer. The Archer Queen here is 1 HP, dude. Oh my god, my Magic Archer absolutely popping off. Are we gonna get the Witch here? There are 4 skeletons coming in hot. Oh my god, I'm pretty scared about it. Please Witch, please Witch, please Witch. Oh no way, this Stellaris absolutely bamboozled my Archer Queen. That's unlucky. But I do think we have a strong deck to bring it home. Miner here should scoop up a Nature Born here, which is, look at the Magic Archer value, dude. Oh my god. That's what I'm talking about, bro. There's just, right now, I don't think there's anything better than a Magic Archer just absolutely raining down shots. Archer Queen gonna be invisible here, and the Nature Born not gonna have enough time to heal up, and that's gonna be round number four without the King Tower. Which means now all the opponents that went for a two star gizmo, they're gonna get dumped on by a King Tower. King Tower in the middle here. I honestly don't think this opponent is going to be able to do anything here. Miner is gonna be onto the Witch. He's got the Ice Whiz block, which is kind of weird to play that up front. Look at that Magic Archer, dude. Magic Archer, like, just don't play the Witch against Magic Archer. Magic Archer is gonna be doing so much damage against you, which is just never gonna be an option. I don't know, I think right now we have to protect our support troops here. Do a Valkyrie and a Wizard and a BK so that there's no way this guy is getting near our Archer Queen Magic Archer combos, because these are the most valuable troops ever. He has a mirror, which is honestly just, he's level 12 heroes, I honestly do like. It's just not gonna be your day, my guy. It's not gonna be your day. Magic Archer absolutely popping off once again. And honestly, I don't think there's anyone to stop us right now. Magic Archer, Archer Queen? Oof. All right, here we have, honestly, Magic Archer center planted, dude. Miner's gonna be onto the Archer Queen, which is pretty awesome. The Magic Archer is just like, I honestly, dude, I don't know why people are still going for a Witch. Look at the Magic Archer, absolutely ding. Archer Queen is gonna get that. Are we gonna win here? The skeletons, Archer Queen Invisibility? Let's go, dude. Oh my god, I honestly thought we didn't have it because our BK got deleted, but nah-uh. That ain't happening, dude. Honestly, Miner here is going to be acting as a decoy. Switches lanes. He goes for a weird Ice Whiz block, which I honestly doubt that'll ever work. And right now, Magic Archer raining down shots. Monk, Archer Queen lined up. It's GG's. It's well played. Good game. Let's move on to the next Rumble, dude. All right, hero selection. Monk, Wave Master. Ugh. Dark Baron, Royal Champion. Disgusting. Really? Give me Natureborn, bro. Natureborn Monk? Oh, Archer Queen BK again? We even have the training camp, dude. Okay, we're definitely going Archer Queen BK here. Let's try to keep everybody nice and tucked in, which is why I'm playing BK behind. I really don't want to give him the isolation, which I am. SK gonna be booping back the BK so that the SK doesn't get any more isolations. Wavemaster gonna be stunning. BK is still under our SK is onto our BK, but we have invincibility popped. Invisibility now takes the other, oh, but the double ultimate ability are going to be absolutely deleting us. Very unfortunate. Musketeer, Mega Knight, Lumberjack, Spear Goblin. Honestly, I'm going to go for some two elixir cheap options because I want to get a training camp ASAP. So here, basically, we placed both heroes right next to the training camp. We don't really care about the Lumberjack dying here, and the Archer Queen training camp combo is just going to be shredding the whole board. GG's, round number two in the pocket, and honestly, if we keep that strategy up, it's going to do a lot of damage. I don't really want... The thing is, if this Rumble goes late game, two Elixir Minis are going to be... We're going to have so much Elixir on our hand, so I'm going to go Bandit. Bandit, honestly, another great mini here because it's going to be able to dissipate both heroes. If it gets to dissipate on both heroes, it's going to chain ultimate abilities and just absolutely destroy your opponent. Archer Queen training camp combo is just... These guys just can't do anything against it. Look, Archer Queen here with a damage boost. It's just crazy value. It's just crazy value. God, everybody's just... Everybody's getting deleted, dude. Okay, our opponent here has Dark Goblin and Archer, which is going to be very, very scary. But honestly, Archer Queen, training camp, damage boosted, cleans up the lobby, dude. It's just... Wow. Wow. What kind of training camp is that, dude? What? Did this man just go training camp front lane? What? Okay, I'm only facing level 12 heroes, dude. Like, what are these robots doing against me? Look at the bandages. I honestly don't think the fisherman on the training camp is going to be such an issue here. Nobody's going to get isolated, and they're both going to get the training camp boost. Archer Queen isn't stunned. Look, when the Archer Queen's going to be invisible... Like, Archer Queen is actually doing, like, 5 damage a shot here. What is going on, dude? That's how strong the combo is. 5 damage a shot. Multiplied by 3. Multiplied by how fast she hits, dude. I'm not kidding when she does 30 damage per second, dude. I'm not kidding. Look at the bandit. Dark Goblin's not gonna be enough, dude. Dark Goblin, ooh. Thank God we got him early, dude. Let's go another W. So basically here, look at the miner. Oh, he has a fisherman. Miner's gonna be just trying to get our... Is he gonna be enough? Everybody's onto our training camp, dude. Oh, no. Oh, no, but the bandit's kind of dashing pretty nicely, though. Ooh, I think he might get us here. But the bandit! Bandit, come on once again, please! Okay, that's okay. Alright, he gets round 8. Because he's going all in on my training camp, which is what you have to do. If you let my Archer Queen training camp go to town, you're dead, man. Okay, basically right now our Spiragum is gonna get the E-Wiz. Oh, he's not. The miner's tanking. I don't know about that miner, dude. You're kind of leaving our Archer Queen alone, and that's just a lot of damage. I don't think you can afford to do that, my guy. I don't think you... Look at that. Our Archer Queen's going to do 4 damage a shot here. Come on, bandit. E-Wiz Pancaker. Oh, you've got to be kidding me, dude. You've got to be kidding me. No way. E-Wiz 3-star. Ugh. Wow, well played, well played. We gotta give this man the well played here. That's unfortunate, dude. That is unfortunate. Thank you guys for tuning into this video until the end. You guys are amazing. I'll see you guys in another video. Wake up, filthy. Yeah, I'm gonna cool with a cutter.